What's going on, guys? In this video, I'm going to show you how to use Finviz for free and how you can use this to find stocks to trade. Finviz is known for having one of the best stock screeners in the industry. A stock screener is different from a stock scanner. A screener is designed more for swing traders and position traders because the pricing is not in real time, but you can still use a screener for finding intraday opportunities. And in this video, I will show you how to set that up. A scanner is more for active traders who want real-time pricing information as it's happening. A screener is great for creating a watch list and looking for potential plays. The website is www.finviz.com. Once you're on the website, you'll see the preset screeners here, like the top gainers, new high, overbought, etc. Now, I'm going to show you how you can create your own screener, as well as show you some of the settings that I've used to find some trading opportunities. On the menu bar, click on Screener. Now, this page is where you'll be able to set up the criteria that you're looking for, whether you plan on looking for stocks for investing, day trading, or swing trading. There are three tabs that you'll notice here: Descriptive, Fundamental, and Technical. The Descriptive tab is where you'll be able to filter out the general information, such as the market cap, the relative volume, float size. You can even filter out the sector and the industry. The Fundamental tab is where you'll be able to filter information such as the PE ratio, sales growth, the current ratio, and a bunch more other options that you could play around with. The Technical tab is where you'll be able to find filters that can help you identify the price action. You can filter stocks based on the SMAs, the volatility, the gap percentage, RSI, and even the candlesticks. This screener provides you with a lot of different filters that you can use to help narrow down your selection. The first type of screener setting that we're going to go over is a breakout screener. This screener will look for stocks that has the potential to break out. The settings that I'm going to show you will target the small to mid-cap stocks, but you can also use this to target big caps. You will just need to adjust the market cap number. Let's start with the descriptive tab. For the exchange, just leave it to any. This way, the screener will look for stocks in AMAX, NASDAQ, and NYSE. For the market cap, I like to set mine to mid-cap under 10 billion. Small caps are more volatile compared to the big caps, but if you also want to trade big caps, then you can just adjust this number. Change the average volume to over 300K. This will screen for stocks that trade an average daily volume of 300K. Volume is very important when it comes to trading. You want to make sure that the stock that you're trading has a lot of volume so you can easily get in and out of your position. If there's not much volume, then you might have troubles with selling your position. Also, if you're not sure what these filters are, all you have to do is hover your mouse over the filter and it will show you the definition of what this filter is for. For example, if you hover over the average volume, it says here that this is the average number of shares traded per day. For the current volume, set it to over 1 million. A lot of volumes can indicate a strong momentum. Set the relative volume to over 2. Relative volume is displayed as a ratio. This calculates the current volume of the day to the 3-month average volume. If the relative volume is greater than 1, then that means the current trading volume is greater than the 3-month average volume. If the relative volume is less than 1, then that means the current trading volume is less than the average volume. And if the relative volume is 2, then that means the current volume is 2 times greater than the average volume. And for the industry, I like to set it to stocks only unless you also want to trade ETFs. I also like to set the price from a minimum of $1 to a maximum of $20. The reason for this is because it's much more common to see a stock going over 100% in one day if the stock price is less than $20. For example, it's much more common to see a $5 stock reach $10 in one day than it is to see a $20 stock reach $40 in one day. Although it does happen, but just not as common compared to the lower price stocks. Now, go to the technical tab. For the 20-day simple moving average, set it to price above SMA 20. Simple moving average is the average price over a specified period. If you are using the SMA 20, then this calculates the closing price of the past 20 days divided by 20. If the price is above the moving average, then that indicates that it's currently trending up. You also want to set the price above the 50 SMA and the 200 SMA. The 200 SMA is what a lot of traders are looking at, and this is because it's taking 200 trading days into consideration. The longer moving averages are considered to be more reliable trend indicators. If the 50 SMA is above the 200 SMA and the 20 is above the 50 SMA, then this tells you that the trend is up for each of those timeframes. Okay, so based on the criteria that we set up, the screener found 12 stocks that fit the criteria. You can also change the view of the list by clicking on the charts tab. This will show you the charts for each of the stocks that was filtered. Alright, now the next thing that I like to look at is the float size. Float is the number of available shares that the public can trade. The lower the float, the more volatile the stock can get. Click on the ownership tab and here you can see the float size for each of the stock. The first on the list is ADT. Now, I'm going to cross off ADT because the float size is too big for the types of plays that I'm looking at. I like to stay under 200 million for the float size, if possible. Let's take a look at AKUS. This one only has 36 million float and a decent volume. Okay, so when you see a chart like this, where it gaps up really high and then just moves sideways, this means that this stock was bought out or they merged with another company. Let's take a look at what the news is for this stock. And there you go. There was a news that came out about a $610 million buyout deal with Eli Lilly. So this one's going to be off the list because this will just move sideways. sideways. The next one is AMPX. The float size is just under 15 million, and the volume for today was 7.9 million, and it has an average volume of 3.47 mil, so that's good. Alright, so you can see here that it bounced from the $6 support and it reached over $10. This almost gained 100%. It pulled back today, most likely from profit selling, and because it couldn't stay above the $11 resistance. It also seems to be forming a potential bull flag. The support zone is from $9 to $8, so as long as this stock doesn't drop below $8, then it could still rise. This is something I would put on the watch list. Ideally, I would like to see this hold above $8, and I would only enter if it breaks and it stays above $10. The stop loss will be below $8, and for the target, you can use the size of the flag's pull. In this example, the size of the pull is $5. You then add the $5 to the $10 entry point and you would get a target of $15. So for this trade, you would be risking $2 to potentially make $5. The risk to reward ratio is just over 2, which is the minimum risk to reward ratio that you should be looking for. Don't trade anything less than 2 to 1 risk to reward ratio. Alright, the next on the list is AVEO. Let's take a look at the chart. Okay, so this one seems like another buyout catalyst. Let's take a look at the news. So you can see here they were acquired by LG Chem. So we'll skip this one. Okay, next is CABA. I'm gonna cross this off the list because I don't like trading stocks close to $1. Alright, so you basically go through the list and quickly look at the chart for each one and see if you like any of the chart, the price action, and if there's good risk to reward ratio. The last symbol I want to show you from this list is NEX. I'm currently looking at the monthly chart. You can see here that it broke out of the $6 resistance, and because it's on a monthly chart, the breakout is stronger. The longer the time frame, the stronger the key levels are, and so if those key levels break, especially on a monthly chart, then it results in a strong breakout. You can see here that it's currently approaching another supply zone, which is from $20 to $23. It could get rejected around here, or if it breaks above $23, then it could possibly go for another multi-month breakout run. Alright, so now once you've narrowed down your selection, it's time to create a watch list. In your watch list, you don't just add the stock symbol because you might forget what to do with it. You need to add details about what your trading plan is for that stock. For example, IMPX and NEX showed the most potential. You then write down if there's any patterns, where your entry is, where your stop loss is, and what your target is. You can also add notes. The more details that you have, the better. This will help you stay organized and be prepared so when the time comes, you'll know how to execute the trade. Another setting that I want to show you is how to set up the screener to find gappers. Stocks that gapped up usually means there's a lot of volume and there's a probability that it might continue moving in that direction. A gap up play will look something like this. Let's say the stock closed at $6. Now the next day during pre-market, it opens at $7. This means the price increased by 16.67%. When this happens, a lot of traders will be keeping an eye on this because a gap up is a bullish indicator. Now it doesn't mean you enter right away. You still need to wait until the price action builds a clear support and resistance so you know where to enter and where to exit. What usually happens is it forms a pre-market resistance and support, so you need to wait until the market opens and enter if it can break above the pre-market resistance and exit if it breaks below the support level. Now it doesn't always work out like this. It could also drop after the market opens, especially if it gapped up a high percentage causing the short sellers to come in. This is why you need to make sure you respect your stop loss. On the descriptive tab, I like to change the market cap to under 10 billion. You can adjust this to your preference. Make sure to change the average volume to a minimum of 300K, and for the relative volume, set it to over 2. And for the industry, I like to set it to stocks only. That way it doesn't screen for ETFs. For the float size, if you want to target only small to mid-cap stocks, then change this to under 100 million. Float is the number of available shares that the public can trade. The lower the float, the more volatile the stock is. Set the price from a minimum of $1 to a maximum of $20. Alright, now let's move on to the technical tab. Here is where you can change the gap percentage. You can choose to look for stocks based on how high or how low they gap. I like to set the gap up percentage to a minimum of 4%. This means the stock price opened 4% higher than it closed the day before. Gap ups are considered bullish. You want to keep the minimum to around 4 to 7% because this means the stock still has room to run. If the stock has already gapped up over 70% or 80%, then this might be overextended, which means people who bought in early will start taking profits. Anything above 70% could be a potential candidate for a short position instead of a long position. You can see here that it found 7 stocks based on the criteria that we chose. You can also click on the charts button to view the charts for each of those symbols. Now, not all of these stocks that show up in your results will be good. Go through the same process as we did earlier and look at the charts more closely and try to identify any patterns, any key levels. You can use your trading platform to do this, or you can use TradingView, which offers a free charting platform with a ton of available tools. Another thing that you can do on Finviz is you can filter out stocks by patterns. So if you go back to the technical tab and click on the drop-down menu for patterns, here you can choose a pattern from the list. For example, let's say you want to see stocks with a double top. You can then see all the different stocks that formed a double top. If you want to narrow down the list, then you can add more filters. And from there, you can analyze the charts further. Finviz also offers heat maps. This lets you quickly see how the different stocks in the different sectors are performing. The red color means those stocks are down, and the brighter the red color is, the more down it is. The green color means those stocks are up, and the brighter the green color is, the more up it is. On the side here, you can add some filters. You can view the heat map of the S&P 500, the world, a full map of the market, and ETFs. You can also change the period of the performance. And that's it. If you have any questions or requests, just leave a comment down below. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. I'll be posting contents about trading every single week. Thank you for watching.